Faith is a powerful personal force that enables you to express supernatural energy that overcomes all restriction and creates the world that you want. The personal power to recreate life's reality into exactly what you want it to be.
A fine romance.
Let me say this. You show me a self-centered person, and I will show you a dissatisfied person.
My friend, this is...
What's on the list? Health, wealth, prosperity, success, all temporal, material things. And He is a God who is concerned about fulfilling things on a spiritual level, whether you ever receive anything on a temporal level. And I didn't find these things on the want list. Humility, brokenness, repentance, holiness, purity of heart, worship, sacrifice, unselfishness, sacrificial love, not so much.
And that they'd been learned to think self-centered. Everything in their curriculum was how to develop yourself, how to express yourself, how to be a significant kind of person. And I realized that we have a tremendous barrier of secular education in this generation to overcome, to get a clear and scriptural picture of what the Bible says about being a servant. He warned them not to make Him known, and He was not seeking fame or popularity, contrary to the ambitions of many contemporary Christians. Just as hard to land as the servanthood is in the nature of God Himself. Being a servant is one of the most godly things that you can ever be. It doesn't mean you're inferior or second rate. It means you're following a divine pattern.
If then you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, appears, then you also will appear with Him in glory. Put to death, therefore, what is earthly in you: sexual immorality, impurity, passion, evil desire, and covetousness, which is idolatry. On account of these, the wrath of God is coming.
That's the spirit of Jesus. He does not come to be served, He comes to serve. And anyone who has the spirit of Jesus will have the same attitude.